So what I am going to start working on now, I suppose, is reinstalling the truck side of the harness in the truck. So let's go ahead and get that knocked out real quick. All right, so check this out, you guys. Today, I did a thing. Bam! Let there be light. Went and copped these LED shop lights today on the cheap. So now, I can actually see what the heck I'm doing over here. So now that I can actually see, I can actually get some shit done on this thing. Now that I got it in the garage, I can actually not worry about being snowed on and rained on and being freezing cold. You know, it's finally time to get this thing done. So when reinstalling the harness, as per Brendan mentions in his OBS video, I went ahead and removed these two 15 millimeter nuts that are retaining the master cylinder against the wall. Now you want to be careful when you're reinstalling the harness this way, because the only thing holding this master cylinder in place now is these brake lines. So as you pull this forward and try to make room for your harness to come through, you gotta be very careful that you don't kink, break, or damage your brake lines in any way. Otherwise, that's just more stuff you gotta rerun and redo. So if you can snake the harness through without having to remove that, that's on you, but it's definitely a lot easier when you remove this master cylinder from the booster there. Then pretty much the harness just drops right through. All right, so underneath the truck, I'm plugging in the park neutral safety switch, and I just wanted to point out that to get this connector in, and probably this one when I actually get to this one, I did have to bust out the hairdryer and heat it up again because some of the residual glue left inside the plug made it difficult for me to get this plug plugged in there. But after heating it with the hairdryer for about 2 minutes or so, you know, I was able to plug it right in. So just figured I would point that out. All right, guys, so at this point I've got the truck side of the harness pretty much back installed and ready to go. Pretty straightforward. Just take your time, like I said, when you're pulling this master cylinder forward. That way you don't risk kinking or breaking any of your brake lines there. But main bulkhead connector is plugged in and locked down. Fuse box is all plugged in and locked down. As you can see here, when it comes time to merging our engine harness, we'll just have to plug these three connectors in and we'll be good to go. So yeah, moving on from there. I did pull the intake off just to help drop the, you know, wiring behind the transmission and stuff like that, making it a little bit easier, and also to plug in this oil pressure sensor plug there. But once the engine harness goes back on, the intake will be in place. So all right, so I went ahead and took a couple of minutes and got the intake all bolted back down. But before I bolted it down, I just took it down to my basement and gave it a nice bath real quick, because it had about, I don't know, 20 years of funk and gunk all over it. So I figured giving it a nice bath wouldn't hurt it. So now that I got the intake pretty much back on and locked down, I'm going to go ahead and start stringing that engine harness along. So I'll holler at you guys when I'm done with that. Alrighty, guys, so I got all the engine harness back and reinstalled on the motor, and I had to remove the brake booster again to snake the main harness under there, just because, you know, it just looked tidier running this way and underneath as opposed to like straighten over this brake booster here. That way all my cables weren't all bunched up. Alright, so one of the last things that I've got to do as far as the wiring goes is I've got to wire in this three-wire connector for our three-wire coolant temp sensor. And the reason we need a three-wire coolant temp sensor is because our truck motor LM7 only came with a two-wire. As you can see down here, our plug only has two wires here. Now, with the three-wire sensor, you obviously got the two wires that feed the PCM and keep it happy, and then that third wire is the one we ran, and that's going to feed our gauge on the dash cluster there. So once we go ahead and clip that plug and wire that one in, theoretically our gauge should work just fine. And I believe this coolant temp sensor is from like a, I want to say like a 98 F-body Camaro. I'm not 100% sure, but either way, that is the part number you need for it. And like I said, this three-wire replaces our stock two-wire, and that'll allow our gauge to work. So I'm gonna go ahead and get that wired in. Alright, so I got the new coolant temp sensor installed, as well as our three-wire connector all soldered and taped and loomed up and looking purdy. So technically, when the truck is running, our factory gauge on our dashboard cluster should work. I also realized that I didn't give you guys the part number for that three-wire pigtail, so there goes that. So yeah, moving on. Alrighty guys, so we got our engine harness back in and reinstalled. And we've also got our truck harness also ran and reinstalled, and everything looks pretty good. And with the exception of this little bit of wiring here that needs to be loomed up and covered, I think everything looks pretty good. Installing the harnesses was pretty straightforward. I did have to pull this master cylinder off again because when I initially ran the engine harness, I initially had it running across this ABS box, and I just didn't really like the looks of that. So rerouted it a little nicer, and like I said, once this is all loomed and taped up, it'll look really nice. As far as the wiring underneath is concerned with the transmission, here, I'll show you. We've got our neutral safety switch from the OBS harness plugged in, and this is the gear selector indicator plug from the LS harness, and here is the plug that we added that ties this plug in with the OBS harness. And just dangling off there is the LS harness gear park neutral safety switch, which I guess I could just cut that plug off, but whatever, it's not bothering me right now, so I'm just gonna leave it for now. But everything works. The only thing I still need to get plugged in is a couple of oxygen sensors, and I gotta get the starter hooked up. So other than those couple of things, you know, we're moving along pretty good. Let me explain one thing to you guys. I want to show you something real quick. Now, when I first was doing my initial tests and powering up the harness, you know, when you turn the key forward, as you can see, voltage gauge works, all our gauges coming on, saying we're in park, the buzzer's buzzing, radio comes on. Now watch this, when I turn on the left turn signal, the wipers came on. Same thing when I did, when I turn on the hazards. When I turn on the hazards, the wipers come on. Turn them off. Right turn signal seemed to work fine. When you turn the wipers on, the wipers work fine. So you gotta understand, when I discovered that when you hit the left turn signal and the wipers came on, I got all sorts of frustrated, wondering what the F did I get mixed up in my harness as I was, like, you know, moving wires around. And, you know, it's really easy to think that you mix something up, because that is just, you know, really strange behavior right there. So anyway, I started to think about it long and hard, and I couldn't think of anything that I may have gotten mixed up. So I started to jump around online, and I came to a forum that suggested, you know, because the guy on the forum was pretty much describing the exact same symptoms, and he suggested check your grounds. Now, this ground wire here is normally bolted to the radiator support, which obviously I've got the radiator support removed for our swap here. But anyway, watch what happens when I reconnect this ground here. I'm trying to do it. Try to do it with one hand holding the camera. Just bear with me. All right, so we got our ground wire reconnected. Now let's go and try our turn signals again. Key on, left turn signal. No wipers. Right turn signal, no wipers. Hazards. No wipers. Wipers. Wipers are working fine. So you gotta understand, when I realized that, you know, it was a big weight off my shoulders, because I thought I had gotten something mixed up in the harness. But, you know, that just goes to show how important ground wires are in your electrical system. So make sure you don't forget any of those, and definitely don't get them all mixed up. But it's coming along. Like I said, I thought it was something with my multifunction switch. So I started to tear apart the steering column and this, that, and the other thing. And You know, once I started testing everything under there, everything seemed to be working fine. I didn't see any burnt wires or anything. So, it started to frustrate the F out of me. So, I'm glad I discovered that article on that form that I read. So, anyways, moving along, everything is pretty much good to go. Now that the harnesses are back in, you know, I would like to hit the key and try to start it. However, I still need to get some transmission lines reconnected here, and I gotta get my oxygen sensors bolted up and just gotta, you know, do a little bit more piecing together before we can, do an initial fire. I guess I could probably like loop the trans lines together for now, but that's just kind of hack. Might as well just get it done. But anyways, you guys, I appreciate you guys sticking around, and the wiring is officially done. Okay, so I know this was a long, 4 or 5 videos or however many videos this was, but like I said, when it comes to this LS swap stuff, you know, the wiring is, you know, pretty much the main aspect of it. And like I said, I could have just bought an engine harness and been done with it, but I still would have had to integrate, you know, my speedometer, my tach, all that other gauge stuff. So I figured, you know, just do it. So anyways, moving along, and the next one will be probably reinstalling the core support and all that stuff, and getting the fuel lines and everything all wrapped up, and continue on from there. So I'll see you in the next one. And I gotta know if this thing will start, or if it does anything. So here it goes. So it fires. And according to the gauge, we had oil pressure. So yeah.